Welcome to Bazaar Maths Online Classes.
In this video, we will discuss about the determinant and the Cramer's rule for the practice set 1.3. So, first of all, see what is meant by determinant. Here, the determinant is nothing but it is the arrangement of rows and columns enclosed by the two vertical lines. That means there is an arrangement of numbers or alphabet in the rows and columns, and that arrangement is enclosed by two vertical line is known as determinant. Here generally the determinants are denoted by the capital letters like D, A, B, C, etc. So here see the example. Suppose D equal to, this structure is given A, B, C, D. Here in this arrangement, there are two rows, that is R1 and R2, and there are two columns, that is C1 and C2. So this is the arrangement which contains rows and columns. And this arrangement is enclosed by two vertical lines, then such arrangement is nothing but the determinant. Then see the value of determinant. Value of determinant. Here, in this determinant, there are two rows and two columns. So here, order of this determinant is 2. Order is equal to 2. In 10th standard, only the determinants having order 2 are given. Then see what is meant by value of determinant. Here if D equal to, again take the same example A, B, C, D, then its value is A into D minus B into C. Its value is A into D minus B into C. Here A and D, these elements are known as diagonal elements. Then B and C, these elements are known as non-diagonal elements. So here simply take the product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. So this is the value of any determinant. See the example. For example, suppose D equal to, determinant is given 2, 3, 4, minus 1 is equal to. Here use this formula AD minus BC. That means take the product of diagonal elements minus the product of non-diagonal. So take here 2 into minus 1 minus 4 into 3 or 3 into 4, we can take 3 into 4 is equal to, so 2 into minus 1 equal to minus 2 minus 3 into 4, 3 into 4 is equal to 12. So we have minus 2 minus 12 is equal to minus 14. So here this is the value of any determinant. Only we have to remember this simple formula, that is AD minus BC. That means the product of diagonal elements minus the product of non-diagonal elements. Then next point is Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule. Using this rule, we can find the solution of simultaneous equations. So this is the third method to solve the given simultaneous equations. So in this Cramer's rule, we have to write the given simultaneous equation in this specific format. So write equations in the form of, first equation is suppose a1x plus b1y is equal to c1, and second equation is a2x plus b2y equal to c2. Here a1, a2, these are the coefficients of x, b1, b2, these are the coefficients of y, and c1 and c2, these are the constant numbers. So we have to write the given simultaneous equation in this format. Then take the determinant d. D equal to in mod a1, b1, a2, b2. So here in the first column, write the coefficients of x, and in the second column, write the coefficients of y, and here find its value by this method, by using this formula AD minus BC. Then next one is DX. This is the second determinant. In this second determinant, only we have to replace first column, that is the coefficients of x, by the constants C1, C2. So C1, C2, then remaining column B1, B2 as it is. This is the value of determinant DX. Then next determinant is dy is equal to, in this determinant only replace the second column by the constant, that means replace the coefficients of y by the constant c1 c2. So we have a1 a2, this first column remains as it is, and instead of b1 b2 write the constant, that is c1 c2, and again find its value. Then finally, in Cramer's rule, the formula is given. Value of x is dx upon d, and value of y is dy upon d. So using this formula, we can find the values of x and y. That means we can find the solution of given simultaneous equation. So it's a very, very simple method. Only we have to remember these three determinants, that is d, dx and dy. So in d, take the coefficients of x in the first column, coefficients of y in the second column. Then in determinant dx, only replace the coefficients of x by the right side numbers, that is c1, c2. Here coefficients of y remains as it is. Then in the determinant dy, replace the coefficients of y, that is b1, b2, by the constant c1, c2. Find here values of all these determinants, and finally use the formula given by the Cramer's, that is x equal to dx upon d and y equal to dy. Formula x equal to dx upon d and y equal to dy upon d, we can easily solve the given simultaneous equation. So here with the help of this formula, we can solve the next practice set, that is practice set 1.3. The MCQ problems. See the practice set 1.3. See the first question. Fill in the blanks with correct numbers. Here we have to fill the value in these empty boxes. Here the value of determinant is given. Only simply apply the rule, that is product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. So here 3 into 5, so 3 into 5 minus here 2 into 4, 2 into 4, that means product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. Then simplify this, 3 5s are 15, minus 2 4s I already given, 15 minus 8, then the value of determinant will be 7. Then see the question number 2. Find the values of following determinants. Again, it's a very, very simple question. Only take the product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. So simplify this. Take the product of diagonal elements minus 1 into 4 minus product of non-diagonal elements, that is 7 into 2. And simplify this. Here minus 1 into 4 minus 4 minus 7 2s are 14. Minus 4 minus 14, that will becomes minus 18. Next, again take product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. So here its value is 5 into 0 minus 3 into minus 7. 3 into minus 7. We know that 0 into any number? 0. here take the product of sign first of all, minus into minus plus, 3 7 is 21, 21 plus 0, then its value is 21. Then see the third problem, again take product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. So we have 7 by 3 into 1 by 2 minus 5 by 3 into 3 divided by 2. Then simplify here, take the product of numerator in the numerator and product of denominator in the denominator. So 7 into 1 that is 7 upon 3 2 are 6 minus, here don't cancel this with 3 because its denominator will be same. Then 5 3 is 15 upon 3 2 are 6. As the denominator is same, so we can write only one times and we can take addition subtraction of numerator. So here 7 minus 15 upon this denominator 6 as it is. Then 7 minus 15 equal to minus 8 divided by 6. Then simplify this fraction. Here both numbers are multiples of 2. So 2 3 are 6 and 2 4 are 8. So value of this determinant is minus 4 divided by 3. So in this way we can find the value of determinant. It's a very simple exercise. These are the very very simple problems. We can write this problem or we can draw the screenshot also.
Is equal to
That means here given the x, only replace the coefficients of x by the constants and coefficients of y remains as it is. Again solve by the same formula, product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal. So we have 10 into 3 minus minus 4 into 5. Simplify this, 10 3s are 30 minus into minus plus 4 5s are 20. So we have 30 plus 20, that is 50. This is the value of dx. Then similarly find the value of dy. So in dy replace the coefficients of y by the constants. So first column as it is here, only change here second column, instead of coefficients of y take the constant 10 5. So we have 10 5 and find its value. Again take the product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. So we have 3 into 5 minus 10 into 4. 3 5s are 15 minus 10 4s are 40. So we have 15 minus 40, that is minus 25. These are the values of determinant d, dx and dy. Then finally, by Cramer's rule, we have x equal to, formula is given, dx upon d. Put here values, the value of dx is 50 divided by value of d is 25. Then simplify this, 25 ones are 25, 25 twos are 50, that is 2. So value of x equal to 2. X equal to 2. Then use the second formula for y. Y equal to dy upon d. Here value of dy is minus 25 upon value of d is 25. Here 25 ones are 25. Answer is minus 1. So finally, the solution is, we have to write this solution in order pair form. So x comma y is equal to value of x is 2 comma value of y is minus 1. So here this is the required answer. So this is the Cramer's rule. We can write this or we can draw this screenshot here.
So we have 2 into minus 1 by 2
minus 3 into 1, this 2 to get cancelled. We have minus 1 minus 3, that is minus 4. This is the value of determinant D. Then, next determinant is dx. So, in dx, only replace the first column, that means the coefficients of x, by the constant. So, 2, 1 by 2. Then, second column as it is, 3 minus 1 by 2 as it is. Again, find its value. Take the product of diagonal elements minus product of non-diagonal elements. We have 2 into minus 1 by 2 minus 3 into 1 by 2. Here don't cancel 2 because your denominators are equal. So we have minus 2 divided by 2 minus 3 divided by 2. If the denominators are equal, write down only one time, take the addition subtraction of numerators. So minus 2 minus 3. We have minus 5 upon 2. Here this is the value of determinant dx. Then similarly find the value of determinant dy. So dy is equal to, in dy only change the second column. That means instead of the second column, take the right side numbers. First column as it is, 2, 1 as it is. Then instead of coefficients of y, take the constant, that is 2, 1 by 2. 2, 1 by 2. Again find its value, roots is same. Product of diagonal element minus product of non-diagonal element. So we have 2 into 1 by 2 minus 2 into 1. Here this 2, 2 get cancelled. 1 minus 2, 1 minus 2 becomes minus 1. Then finally, use the Cramer's rule, use the formula. By Cramer's rule, we have x equal to value of x is dx upon d. Put here value of dx is minus 5 by 2 upon value of d is minus 2. Here this minus minus get cancelled, this 2 comes in denominator here. We have 5 divided by 2 into 4. So 5 divided by 8, this is the value of first variable x. And second formula is y equal to dy upon d is equal to, put here value of dy, that is minus 1 upon value of d is minus 4. This minus sign get cancelled, we have 1 by 4. So y equal to 1 by 4. Therefore, the solution is, finally write the solution. The solution is, variables are x, y, so x, y is equal to, the value of x is 5 by 8, comma, the value of y is 1 by 4. So in this way, we can use here Cramer's rule to solve.